If you've ever seen a turbocharged drag car blow huge clouds of white smoke as it backs off at the end of the drag strip, or alternatively a turbocharged streetcar that seems to be pumping out white or blue smoke while stopped stationary at a set of traffic lights, one of the potential causes for these problems may be an oversupply of oil to the turbocharger. Now, turbochargers obviously need a steady supply of high quality and clean engine oil in order to live a long and healthy life, but particularly with ball bearing turbochargers, which are increasingly popular these days, they don't require as much oil as many people think. And if we supply too much oil to the turbocharger core, then it's possible that some of this oil will end up leaking past the turbine piston ring seals, making its way into the exhaust housing and then burning. This is where we see that smoke come from. Now, traditionally, trying to prevent this problem comes down to sizing the oil feed to the turbocharger and using restrictors in that oil feed to try and restrict and control the supply of oil to the turbo core. Of course, this is a little hit and miss, and a lot of it comes down to the base oil pressure or oil supply from the oil pump in the engine. This, of course, isn't the same across every engine. A neat alternative to trying different size oil restrictors in the hope of getting your oil flow just right is an oil pressure regulator like the one here made by Turbosmart. Now, this is very similar to a conventional fuel pressure regulator, and its job is exactly the same. What we're trying to do here is maintain a fixed oil pressure supply to the turbocharger regardless of the engine speed and the oil flow and pressure on the inlet side of the regulator. The regulator plumbs in quite easily. The oil feed to the turbocharger is interrupted. One side goes into the regulator, the other side comes out of the regulator and continues to the turbocharger. And then there is a third line, which is the oil return, and this returns excess oil flow back into the sump. Now, these regulators are simple to fit as well. They're already pre-configured to maintain 40 psi of oil pressure. This is essentially in the range of oil pressure recommendations from most of the big name turbocharger manufacturers.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.